Welcome to the Wild Reef.
Hello and welcome to the second round through the Shedd Aquarium. This time we are 25 feet below street level in the award-winning Wild Reef. This 28,000 square foot complex opened in 2003. With over 25 exhibits and 750,000 gallons, this is an artistic representation of the Apo Island reefs in the Philippines. So to begin is a surge tank that comes with the occasional simulated pounding wave that breaks the surf. The next room is your introduction to the exhibit's idea, to bring you to the diver's perspective, even from outside of the tanks. You're actually in the reef. And to reflect that, for the most part, the walls are alive with fabricated coral. The best examples are these human-sized coral that explains their life cycles. Meanwhile, there's also the first living tank, home to several Chromises, Foxfaces, and Surgeonfish. Through the coral archway, it's impossible not to be captivated by the seemingly rehearsed movement all around. The directions of the fish make three exhibits complement each other in a swirling, intricately patterned circle. The first is the mid-sized predator tank. Just because you're not a shark doesn't mean you can't be intimidating by your size. Though it used to contain barracuda, I was able to spot triggerfish, snappers, groupers, porcupine puffers, and a lot more. The same room has smaller exhibits on the ground for lobsters and the crown of thorns starfish. But the highlight is the 100,000 gallon spectacle known as the schooling fish tank. It's home to over 30 species, damselfish, butterflyfish, triggerfish, and batfish that each follow their own synchronization. It's supported by what lies on top, giving the Wild Reef its immersive purpose of the simulated perspective of a diver, offering you the chance to be in the middle of that tornadic synchronization. As you go further down the line, there are several more smaller tanks. With the coral and the animals blended together, it's like one long painting. If you ever visit, look out for morays, anemone fish, anemones, the mythical mandarin fish, and the peekaboo playing garden eel. In the larger, lengthy, towering tanks, you'll find lionfish, and hidden in the pitch black are flashlight fish, an animal that would be invisible to our eyes if not for their bioluminescent organs located just beneath their eyes. And now, the biggest reason why we are all down here. The Shark Reef, known as the Wild Reef's granddaddy attraction. It's home to around only 10 species. The aquarium states five of them are sharks. I spotted a zebra shark, an animal born striped but becomes spotted as an adult. There were also black tips, known to be the territorial aggressors in a tank. I even saw a massive white-spotted guitarfish, though they aren't actually sharks. What seemed to be the stars, however, were the sandbars, the largest of the five. Together, there's over 20 of them. If you go up and stand close to the 11-foot-tall wall, you'll notice that eventually the 5-inch thick acrylic glass bends upwards, allowing the animals to briefly cruise directly above you. The Shark Reef alone is 400,000 gallons, making it the largest fish exhibit at the Shedd Aquarium. But arguably the most special thing about it though, is no matter how hard you try to look for it, the lighting is so perfect that the back of the tank cannot be found. Opposite to them is the Stingray Way, the most uniquely designed exhibit in the Wild Reef. It's a semi-circular open-top tank where you can partially walk over them and watch ribbon-tail and blue-spotted stingray swim under your feet. After a few more lagoons, the last area brings you back to shore with a mangrove forest. So dense from top to bottom, displaying what kind of shelters are available to fish in these brackish waters. And that is how this summary comes to a close. But if you'd like, stick around to the end to learn more about this attraction. Overall, thank you for joining me through our Apo Island quest in the award-winning Wild Reef. the epicenter of ocean diversity.